Welcome back to The Checkpoint with me, Vivian Kamsimi. I am speaking to Honorable James Jimmy Akena, who is also the UPC party president, and is telling us about the UPC and the Yam North by-election win that his party just got by defeating the National Resistance Movement. Honorable, the party that you are presiding over is visibly stronger in Lango, and many describe it as a tribal party because now you can see that even the current person who is winning against the ruling party is from that region and is within that region. Isn't this enough for you to resign as party president?
Not at all. Because we do have UPC elected at different positions in different parts of the country. It's just at parliamentary level and also currently at LC5 level. In the last 2016 to 2021, we also had a chairman 5 from TESO. In recent times, we've had MPs, TESO, Acholi, West Nile. So it's not particular. You say, okay, you can say that there's a lot of strength and a lot of support in the Lango sub-region, but it's not exclusively in Lango. So it's beyond that one. And also going forward, it's also where we want to strengthen ourselves, to reclaim. Because going back in history, UPC was a national party. May 27th, everybody would converge in Bushenyi. That was like a home for UPC. And we've got a lot of strong support which has existed over time. It's a question of how do we now bring it to bear, especially towards 2026 and forward.
Do you still have a UPC leader from Bushenyi?
Sorry?
Do you have a leader who is a member of UPC in Bushenyi?
There are plenty.
Okay.
Yeah.
But not at the parliamentary level?
No, not at parliamentary level.
Okay, you have them at the chairman.
We've had them at councillors, councillor levels. But it's something which we definitely are going to be working on.
Okay.
For the next round of elections, we're going to be working on to try and see that we field strong and formidable candidates who can represent their people in the Parliament of Uganda.
We have seen other people claiming presidency of this party and their rival factions. You know about them, Mr. Joseph Ocheno, and there is Peter Waluviri. How do these factions affect development in the UPC?
Those so-called factions exist largely in the media and maybe in court, not in the body politic. Both Walubiri and Ocheno were claiming leadership on the eve of the 2021 elections. Where were they in the elections? Did they field any candidates? Were any candidates elected at any position? So that's why I say that they exist largely in the media, where somebody can talk about his so-called position. But when it comes to national elections, where you're facing other political parties and you're competing and you're fielding your candidates, they don't exist. That's the reality of it.
We know you for being soft-spoken. In fact, in the media, we are always saying, Honorable Jimmy Akena, the soft-spoken. But we have not seen you extend a dialogue hand to these people, to these factions. We know you for being a considerate leader, dialogue-oriented, like I just said. But we don't see you reaching out to these people out of court or out of the media and say, you have said this in the media, can we internally have this resolved? What is stopping you from having unity within this party?
We have had meetings, and I think that one of the last meetings which we're trying to do with reconciliation We involved some two bishops to try and help us find a way forward, and they did not yield much. Mm. On the issue of reconciliation, I remain open. But on the interest of UPC fielding candidates, winning elections, participating in democratic processes, I can't compromise there. That was an area of no. How do you compromise? If somebody is trying to hold you back but not trying to see the party go forward, then that one is really trying to injure the party. When it comes to fielding candidates and supporting those candidates who are carrying the UPC flag in any election, I think there we should not have any division. Our divisions we can deal with afterwards. Like in this particular case
show
of.
Up in IAM?
No, not at all.
What does that mean to you?
I know the players. And I know when it comes to elective politics, I really know those who are in the game, and there are those who are going to be bystanders and making maybe commentaries about it. Mm. And unfortunately, that's what we face.
When do you have the elections of party president again in UPC?
Next election will be in 2025.
Okay.
Mm. 2 years down the road.
Are they welcome to participate?
Anybody, any party members are welcome to contest.
Will you be running for the presidency of this country in 2026?
Straight off, as things stand, there has to be processes. As a party, we have been preparing for our National Council, which is supposed to trigger certain events to make the party more prepared and go through certain processes leading towards the 2025 election. But if any of these leaders are interested in the topmost office, it will be available. Contesting will be there, and that the delegate conference of 2025 will set UPC into the 2026 elections.
You see, from what you're saying, you are leaving this to the future. But as people who are serious about taking power of this country, there must be some groundwork done to actually get to contest for leadership and take back this country. Is there anything UPC is doing in that direction?
We are doing it, but I cannot preempt what the decision of the delegates' conference will be, because we're all subject to that decision. So if you're asking me to give you beyond the delegates' conference, I cannot give you anything beyond the delegates' conference, because that power remains with the delegates. That's the power of the delegates' conference. The delegates' conference will set us forward. My mandate goes up to 2025, and therefore I must do all that I can to prepare the party for the next general election. But I cannot project myself beyond the mandate of the delegates' conference, which will sit in 2025 and determine both the leadership, the manifesto, and how we're going to approach that general election.
Okay. Finally, as we wind up this discussion, I just wanted to hear your view on the fact that when you came from exile in 2005, you immediately contested in the 2006 elections and on the UPC ticket at that. And you actually took the election, you won it in your constituency then. You have continued to win in 2011, 2016, 2021. What does that speak of this regime? Are they more lenient in comparison to the previous regimes? Have they created a more democratic environment? What does that speak of this government?
No, when I contested in first in 2006, the situation in that part of the country was dire. A huge part of the people were displaced, were living in internally displaced people's camps, even within the municipality where I contested. And it was one of the single issues which I took up and made the decision that whatever, come what may, we must find a solution. And that's what took me into South Sudan and into Congo to meet with the LRA leadership to try and see if we can get a peace process to go through. Now, on the question of the democratic terrain, we're not yet there. We are getting towards it, but we're not yet there. And that is what informs some of my actions to try and find ways of how can we increase cross-party communication. Because there may come a time where we're going to have a crisis as a country, and if the political parties or the institutions which should underpin the democracy, strong democracy will have need strong parties. And even NRM, which people can talk about, is not as strong as it should be as a political party. It's dominated by, especially the president, how it functions. These institutions, the political parties, are what can help guarantee our democracy. And that is something which is not yet realized. So there's a lot more work to do. And some of us are involved in it and look at it on a longer term basis. That let us try to leave something which is going to be able to endure whatever situations come up.
Honorable Jimmy James Akena, thank you for coming to the Checkpoint. That has been this week's Checkpoint. Until next week, I am Vivian Kamsimi.